up, Sam? Your cargo's been pinged. Move. Now, before someone has eyes on you. Get to your destination ASAP if you don't want to get caught.
Thank you. Doesn't look so hot.
Nothing to worry about. Its functions are temporarily suspended, but they can be restored. I can perform the necessary maintenance at a distribution center. Hurry, though.
Hmm.
When the strain on your BB exceeds sustainable levels, it triggers the production of harmful compounds, and the body, in essence, begins to attack itself. It's called autotoxemia. If your BB's not performing to spec, drop by your private room and see if the incubator helps.
Starting to cramp up. Huh.
Singh's ID. Verifying ID. Clear. All weapons will remain locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you. Decontaminating suit. Rest is advised.
Thanks for bringing more folks into the UCA.
Looks like we're on the chiral network. And with those materials you brought for our chiral printer, we can produce supplies for you here as needed. Think of it as our way of returning the favor. Now head west, and keep on doing what you do.
Good. The distro center's on the network.
Sam, do me a favor. Take your BB to a private room and connect it to the incubator.
Good work.
Dead man, you there? Little help.
Okay, Sam. Remove the pod and connect it to that incubator.
It's in.
Good. A temporary excessive stress. Easily addressed if we return it to its mother's womb.
Mother?
Located in the capital Knot City ICU. Brain dead, of course.
You mean still mother?
Correct. A still mother's womb facilitates a connection between the world of the dead and the BB. And you, in turn, connect yourself to a BB, granting you the ability to sense BTs. These pods were designed to simulate the conditions inside a still mother's womb. BBs need to believe they're in one at all times to function properly. However, we can only maintain this deception for so long, which is why we must periodically update the environmental data by synchronizing it with a still mother via the chiral network. There. The update is in progress. Right now, the pod is synchronizing with the Steel Mother in Capital Knot City and reconfiguring its settings based on the latest data. Returning your BB to the womb in this manner will temporarily reduce its stress levels. That being where it technically belongs, of course.
Kid looks happy.
I'll try adjusting the oxytocin dosage. Autotoxemia should set in much slower from now on. You should remember that BBs are just equipment. Try not to get attached. Each one has been physically removed from its steel mother's womb. A process that renders them unpredictable and prone to failure. No BB on record has remained in service for over a year. It may need to be retired before this expedition is over.
And then? You saying there's no way to keep my BB alive?
You must understand, there is still a great deal we don't know about BBs. As we expand the chiral network and recover more past data, perhaps we'll find our answers. Right. You asked me to look into why the BTs might be reacting to your blood. I spoke with Hartman. We should have your results soon. Anyway, get some rest. You and your BB are both exhausted.
Good night, Sam.
Chained up, still can't leave. But if you can keep making connections, if you can get to me, we can go back east, back home. Thank you. I mean that. It's bad. There are fewer and fewer people in the cities these days. No one's having children anymore. But humans aren't made for living alone. They're supposed to come together, to help one another. And if we as a people can't do that, if we can't reconnect, then, well, it's like Bridget said, extinction.
Come on. Rebuilding America isn't gonna get rid of the BTs. As long as they're still around, there's no escaping it.
But at least we'll have hope. I'll be waiting, Sam. Waiting for you. Come and find me.
Hello, Sam. This is Hartman. Since you're awake, it might behoove you to freshen up. To that end, why not take a shower? It's good for the body and soul, and also my research, as it happens.